The biggest infrastructure project in the Baltic region in the last century is finally under construction. Right now, as we speak, Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania are breaking away from old ties with Russia and steering toward the west. They are doing it with a massive 870-kilometer long high-speed railway called Rail Baltica. This railway is going to link the capitals of Lithuania, Latvia and Estonia all the way to Warsaw and beyond into the heart of Europe. Before we jump on board with Rail Baltica, make sure to track along and subscribe for the latest updates. But why should we care about Rail Baltica? Because apparently it's going to reposition the Baltic states within Europe. How exactly? Let's have a look. Originally, the Baltic states, Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania were connected to Europe by a standard gauge rail. It was the same one used across most of Western Europe. However, during their Soviet occupation, the rail system was converted to the Russian gauge of 1,524 mm. It differed from the European standard of 1,435 mm. This switch made transport complex and tricky because anyone or anything travelling by train had to switch over to a different train at the Polish border to keep going. This really complicated things for travel and trade. For a long time, this meant the Baltics leaned more toward trading with Russia because their railways were set up to go east to west. But things started to change in the 1990s after they got their independence back. They began to turn towards Western Europe. They joined NATO in March 2004 and the European Union in May 2004. While the Baltics were happy with these new connections, Russian President Vladimir Putin did not like this shift. So, some kind of tension was always present between Russia and the Baltic states. This escalated after Russia invaded Ukraine in 2022. At that time, the Baltic states felt a stronger need to connect more with the European Union. This push got even stronger in August 2022 when Rail Baltica got funding from Latvia, which showed it was important not just for easier travel, but also for military reasons. That's when the Rail Baltica project started. Now, you know why this mega project is a huge deal right now? It is because the project is helping the Baltic states to stop relying on Russia and become more integrated with the rest of Europe. Now, let's take a closer look at the project details. Rail Baltica is going to be an 870-kilometer high-speed railway stretching from Tallinn in Estonia all the way down through Latvia and Lithuania to the Polish border, and then connecting to the broader European network. It is a modern, fast, conventional double-track railway that is going to cut the travel time between these capitals in just over 3.5 hours. Right now, the same trip takes more than 7 hours. The railway supports both high-speed passenger and freight services. Passenger trains will travel along at speeds of up to 249 kilometers per hour, while freight trains will operate at a steady pace of 120 kilometers per hour. One of the best parts of Rail Baltica is how it helps the environment. The entire route is being electrified, which is a huge win for sustainability. It is expected to reduce air pollution and cut down CO2 emissions by more than 18% compared to other ways of traveling. This project is really focusing on being eco-friendly, just like many other big projects these days. Now, let's see what's on the schedule. There will be fast rail connections between the Baltic capitals every 2 hours. Also, high-speed trains from Tallinn to Warsaw and Tallinn to Vilnius will run 4 times a day. If you're traveling between Vilnius, Kaunas and Warsaw, you can catch one of up to 10 trains a day. There are also plans for 2 night trains on both the Tallinn, Riga, Kaunas, Warsaw, Berlin and Vilnius, Kaunas, Warsaw, Berlin routes. The project as a whole is going to be amazing, but let's look at some key infrastructure that will make it stand out. We will move from the south to the north to see some of the coolest parts of this project. Let's start in Lithuania and make our way up through Latvia and into Estonia. In Vilnius, Lithuania, the most impressive feature is this brand new train station that they are building called Green Connect. It will be more like a hub surrounded by parks and open spaces, with a roof made from local timber and special gardens that handle rainwater for sustainability. Moving north from there, we come across a huge bridge being built over the Neris River. This bridge is significant here because it is over 1,500 meters long. Yes, almost a mile. They're using a giant drilling machine to put in 376 piles to support the bridge. You can only imagine the amount of metal and concrete going into that. The estimated numbers are about 11,500 tons of reinforcement and 74,000 cubic meters of concrete. Next up, as we cross into Latvia, we hit the bustling center of Riga. Here, they are putting up a new central station that is going to be the busiest passenger hub in all the Baltics. It is going to have a huge glass roof and lots of space. And by lots of space, we mean almost 13,000 square meters. Just a bit away from the station, they are starting work on a new bridge over the Dugava River that will connect directly to the airport. Now, heading into Estonia, the project focuses a lot on nature. They are building special eco-ducts, which are beautiful wildlife crossings. These will be bridges but for animals, so they can safely cross over the railway without any harm. One of these crossings is made of 54 concrete arches, each one weighing 25 tons. They put these together to form a tunnel just for the animals. Our final stop is Ülemiste on the edge of Tallinn. Here they have started building a really impressive new passenger terminal designed by Zaha Hadid Architects. It is right next to the main airport and is set to be a major gateway into Estonia. This terminal is also a link to buses and trams, making it super easy to switch between different types of transport. So, from the green hub in Vilnius to the animal-friendly crossing in Estonia, Rail Baltica is a product of cool infrastructure that is making travel faster and more eco-friendly. But its incredible design and execution do not mean the project was without challenges. Rail Baltica has had its fair share of challenges along the way, just like any big project. According to some people, Rail Baltica in the Baltics is similar to what the UK has seen with its HS2 high-speed rail project. Both projects aim to drastically improve transportation networks, but they have stirred up a lot of criticism. The comparison is especially pointed when looking at costs. In the case of Rail Baltica, the financial burden is significantly heavier for the Baltic States compared to the UK with HS2. For Estonia, for example, the cost of Rail Baltica is roughly 3 times more significant relative to its GDP than HS2 to the UK's GDP. Think about the economic strain it is putting on smaller nations that are undertaking such massive infrastructure improvements. Then there is the issue of money from the EU. The EU is funding 85% of the total cost of the project through its Connecting Europe Facility instrument. If the EU cut back on funding, the Baltic countries would need to make up the difference, which could make more people unhappy with how much is being spent on the project. But despite these concerns, construction hasn't slowed down. It looks like Rail Baltica is too far along to be stopped now. So, when will it all be done? Let's check it out. The project started with designs in 2016. By the next year, 2017, the governments of Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania all agreed to go ahead with the project. Construction of this mega project officially started in 2019. If everything keeps going as smoothly as it has been, some parts of the railway will start being used by 2028 and the whole thing should be finished by 2030. So, if all goes well, it won't be long before this big new train line is up and running. And now, let's discuss the cost of the whole thing. Rail Baltica isn't cheap. It is estimated to cost around 5.8 billion euros, which is equivalent to $6.32 billion. So far, the EU's CEF fund has put in 824 million euros, and it has promised to cover 85% of the entire cost in the end. Despite this high cost, the project is expected to bring a lot of benefits. For example, we have predicted an economic gain of up to 16.2 billion euros. Building Rail Baltica is also expected to create around 13,000 direct full-time jobs and another 24,000 indirect jobs. That's a big boost for the job market. Once the railway is up and running, it'll become part of the EU's North Sea Baltic Corridor. For travellers, this means more train options, with at least one international service running every 2 hours. It will add up to 8 train pairs each way every day. Given all these benefits, the investment in Rail Baltica seems well worth it. What do you think? Share your opinions with us in the comments below. Before you go, make sure to like, share and subscribe for more updates on the latest mega projects. See you in the next one.